Hi korang. So hari ni kita berada di Terata Nur Villa. So untuk segmen Picasso Talk kali ni, kita akan interview seorang artis muda yang berbakat besar, iaitu Juliana. So jom kita kenali siapa dia.
Okay, hi. First of all, thank you so much for having me in this segment Picasso Talk. My name is Juliana. I'm 24 years old. I'm from Bangi. And you can call me a self-made artist lah. I'm also a part-time baker and a creative director at Creative Media Lab. So, from when I was small, my father is a big fan of art. He collects a lot of painting and he has a lot of artist friends. So I developed some minat lah daripada the paintings that I see, the paintings that my father bought. And I also see that there is some sort of freedom in art. So I tried to portray my vision of freedom into a piece of paper. So it started with a small painting, kereta api. It's just straight lines and splashes of art. And I used to draw dalam kelas, malam-malam. Since I was small, daripada tadika lagi. And I would hide them. Not so hide lah, tapi I would like kumpulkan kat dalam satu paper bag and keep it in between the almari, you know. I didn't think that my drawings or any of this has had any value. So today I feel very honored lah to have featured in Picasso Talk and to share you guys what I've done throughout the 12 years maybe. Or 20 years of painting. Usually, dulu, I am always inspired by the sky. I suka tengok sky and I draw balik apa yang I nampak dekat langit tu. Something like this, you know. And the galaxy, the moon. So, benda-benda yang I nampak, I like to draw balik. Tapi of course lah, I'm not the kind of person yang boleh buat realism. I am just a naive artist lah. So, apa nama dia? Usually the time that I draw is bila I balik holiday. But usually at night. Sebab at night macam tenang and tak ada orang, so I can freely draw alone. And it's some sort of a therapy jugalah for me when I'm in apa tengah bercuti ke tengah dalam apa nama dia recovery, then I use my time for painting and that's how I bring my emotions and story through art. The first teacher that my father sent me to, it was Arwah Mansur Ghazali. He was one of the first artists to be sent to London untuk belajar in art. And before he passed away, he shared me his sketchbook. And to me, it's priceless lah sebab you can see all his artwork inside here. Ada banyak lah. And to me, it's a treasure. Kemudian, well, after dia bila dah sakit, I belajar dengan dia punya mentee, which is Encik Faizal. He taught me a little bit more into realism. I studied with Mansur Ghazali. It was more about watercolour. Macam ni, And then when I studied with Encik Faizal, I developed into something like this. Okay. And then when I pursue my study in advertising design, kita ada lah foundation in art, whereby kita belajar visual art and communication. So, I have some paintings tapi dah submit dekat university, but these are some of the sketches lah that I managed to save. And also this one. So kat sana ada banyak teachers sebenarnya yang taught me concept of art. Dia ajar saya lagi proper lah about art. The principle, all the elements. So this one, I tiba-tiba ventured into surrealism. And then from paintings of sky, I ventured into surrealism and then some of portraits. Tapi portraits, I'm quite weak lah at portraits. Lepas tu, I went to, they call it abstract psychedelia. So, when I was dreaming one day, recently sebenarnya, this is last 2 weeks punya painting. I had a dream of just a black wave trying to shade off my life. Tapi, and then ada streaks of colours that come in. So the colour was vivid. Bila I bangun, I lukis balik. So bawah ni, I cannot portray balik lah what life flashes bawah ni. Tapi I drew some galaxies, some, what do you call it, prism, shapes, reflections. So actually it has a lot of meaning. And then I also draw something out of a song. This song is some sort of giving me spirit. It says it's not a road till the end, and it tells me to take it slow and be more, enjoy life more. Macam tu lah, lebih kurang. So when I was young, I used pencil colours, oil pastel and mostly watercolour. Kemudian I tukar kepada poster colour. After poster colour, I change to soft pastel, oil pastel, acrylic. And now I baru start belajar lah dalam oil painting. Tapi I campur, you know, I like to mix media, which is mula-mula acrylic, kemudian atas dia baru I put oil painting. Okay, something like this. I'm still working on this painting, tapi ini contoh lah. So the base of the painting, I use acrylic. Kemudian I used oil. I use marker. I use glitters, diamonds, gum. It's very random lah. Whatever I see around me, I just campak je sebenarnya. But this one took a lot of effort sebenarnya. It took me one day untuk satu persatu susun and gum onto the canvas. But alhamdulillah, maybe under the lampu, maybe it shows some light. But the painting is still not dry yet. And this is the painting I give a name, kamar, which is my room. Ada painting yang I just take about, kalau kecil macam ni, 2 hours. Kalau macam ni pun, if I know what I'm going to draw, it will take me just a few hours, tak sampai 1 hari pun. Tapi a painting like this, it took me a lot of commitment. I drew for few weeks, lepas tu I letak kat belakang almari. Simpan 3-4 bulan, then I keluarkan balik. I have the motivation, then I started drawing balik. Then it took me another few weeks baru siap. And this one maybe dalam seminggu dua, tapi still not done yet, maybe 3 weeks baru siap. Tapi yang lain ni semua satu hari lah, ada 2 hari. But this one took me longer. Kalau masa saya tengah kelas, because my class was once a week, jadi I kena sambung my, I only sambung my painting bila I have my teacher around. So that one took me longer lah. This one was, I couldn't remember whether it was arwah Mansur Ghazali ataupun dengan Cikgu Faizal. But ini adalah tangan yang tengah berdoa lah. This is one of the paintings yang I told you just now that took me the longest. But it was about my hometown, Mersing. So I gathered benda-benda yang paling attract me most dekat Mersing, which is the sunrise. The sunrise there is beautiful. It was the base lah. The base mula-mula I made it just blue and peach. And the sun here is this one. Dia ada texture sikit lah. And then Gerbang Pulau Mawar. Gerbang Pulau Mawar ni is to me the landmark of Mersing. Kalau Paris, Eiffel Tower. Kalau dekat somewhere I don't remember the country, is the Stonehenge. But this one, for Mersing, it's the Pulau Mawar. People are crazy about it and it's getting viral. And then this is the Seri Mersing. So orang banyak kenal Mersing ni daripada Seri Mersing sebenarnya. So we don't exactly know who she is. That's why I kept the face empty. Tapi dia bring such culture, such fashion. I went to the Museum of Mersing and study how Zapin Mersing punya outfit. And then dia punya elements of Mersing. So I drew lah the daun pokok Mersing kat sini. Dia Mersing tu nama dia datang daripada Mersinga, pokok Mersinga. So I draw daun pokok Mersing itu kat sini. And as usual orang dulu pakai selendang, pegang bunga. And I made it extra special lah, tiara for her. Because she's the icon. Macam kalau orang putih, France, it was the Mona Lisa. Kalau yang lain, Johannes Vermeer. But for Malaysia, we don't have yet the icon of Malaysia for art. And I'm trying to bring out Seri Mersing lah into my painting. First of all, the size of the painting is 4x5, if I'm not mistaken. And then there is over 7 layers of painting kat dalam ni sebenarnya. Mula-mula I lukis just the basic and I still feel like it's empty lah. It doesn't look done. But this is what I planned, tapi it doesn't go as planned. So the person that I am, that my friends know, I ni jenis yang extra, suka bling-bling. So I put all over, some glitters, some stars. And then, even though the sky kat belakang ni is sunrise, subuh, tapi I also incorporate some sunset element, which is the awan-awan ni. Kalau you pergi Mersing, you akan nampak awan-awan kat sana warna pink. So I campur sekali lah sunset, sunrise in one place. And then Gerbang Pulau Mawar ni started in a colour that is very ugly, which is ochre. I tried to mix dengan biru, kuning, merah, tapi tak jadi-jadi. So I said, why don't I make it gold? So dia banyak macam critical thinking lah for this art. So, banyak problem solving sikit, you know, yang burung burung helang ni pun started off white. Mula-mula dia burung merpati, tapi I feel like why not make it black? So I cat je lah kali hitam. Lepas tu dia sorang-sorang pula, lukis lah pula kawan dia, macam tu lah. And then bawah ni pun it didn't start off that way. Mula-mula I did different abstract, tapi it didn't work. It doesn't look like macam masuk tema lah. So I macam I was a bit upset sebab the painting didn't end up the way I want it to be, and it looks to me macam demotivated sekejap lah. So I rasa macam dah lah melt je lah all this painting. So I literally make it like a melted effect kat bawah ni. From the atas tu, so dia jatuh, dia jadi melted. Tapi kalau you see it as a water, it became like a reflection lah of the sunset and the sunrise. For this painting, sebenarnya it is an iconic batu lah, batu berlipat daripada Tanjung Kempit, Endau, Bersing. Batu ni, it started off as just maybe from a volcano. It float down dekat pantai. It was just one piece of batu. Tapi sebab hakisan, sebab the pressure of earth, dia berlipat, lipat, 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 and now it became a very iconic statue dekat dalam Mersing tu. And somehow dia ada bawa sedikit makna lah dalam hidup kita. And kepada yang tak nampak tulisan saya dalam lukisan ni, I boleh bacakan lah. This is what I wrote in my point of view. She float effortlessly from the highest ground when life has barely even started. And the force of air, all the elements of the earth, push her to the core. The particles of her being fold and unfold as the water ripple, and it crumples her beauty and delicate surface. She came back stronger as the greatest form of art and the strongest among the rest. With her curves, cracks and scars, fascinated by many but unfelt by all the emotions. And she became the proof of strength. After the storm, she is the history of 330 million years of life, beauty, bliss and cruelty. And that is Batu Berlipat, Tanjung Kempit, Endau. So, I ada susunkan 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 painting. And this is at least I rasa in the span time of 10 years or 12 years. I started drawing from here. You know, it is some sort of a girl dreaming. It is about the same girl yang trying to grow to become a woman. And then this is another one girl trying to escape reality and discover art, trying to venture into her imagination. And then this is another girl which is tied up by commitments. She grew up, she realized that life isn't as easy as it is, but she kept on dreaming. So now this is the girl that she is not the girl she is today, but this is how it turned out lah from all this series. This is the ultimatum for me. But maybe there will be more series after this. But this is this bring quite a lot of meaning sebenarnya, because when I was drawing this, my mother read me Surah Al-Mulk, and that's why I titled this painting as The Sovereignty. The Sovereignty ini adalah maksud kepada Surah Al-Mulk, and these numbers adalah ayat-ayat yang to me, it hits me lah, you know, as a human being. This girl pun sebenarnya, I'll show you the picture. This girl started off pretty and very plain. Tapi because of the destruction of world, because the cruelty of human, you know, she hid her tears under the mask. She became white-eyed, mata putih, and she have all these cracks, all this ikatan, and she's not the same anymore. But Allah tu menjanjikan sesuatu yang baik untuk orang yang baik. And maybe I can read for you what the sentences we were talking about that is related to the painting. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dialah yang menciptakan 7 petala langit yang berlapis-lapis. Tidak akan kamu lihat sesuatu yang tidak seimbang pada ciptaan Tuhan yang Maha Pengasih, maka lihatlah sekali lagi. Adakah kamu lihat sesuatu yang cacat? Kemudian ulangi pandanganmu sekali lagi dan sekali lagi. Nescaya pandanganmu akan kembali kepadamu tanpa menemukan kecacatan dan ia pandanganmu dalam keadaan letih kerana tenaga habis dengan sia-sia. So, 7 petala langit tu adalah the background of this painting. This is the sea. This is the horizon. This is the sky. And this is the galaxy. The earth that Allah has already made is already pretty. And kalau kita cuba untuk cari, memang tak ada celanya. But because of the destruction of human, dia menjadi, you know, greenhouse effect, destruction. Bumi ni jadi sakit lah. Sesungguhnya orang yang takut melanggar hukum Tuhannya semasa mereka tidak dilihat orang dan mereka tidak melihat azab Tuhan, mereka beroleh keampunan dan pahala yang besar. Dan rahasiakanlah perkataanmu atau nyatakanlah sama sahaja keadaannya kepada Allah. Kerana sesungguhnya dia maha mengetahui segala isi hati. So, this girl hid a lot of stories behind her. Setiap manusia pun macam tu juga. Everyone have their own stories. Tapi Allah je lah yang paling tahu isi hati kita. Allah je yang tahu why we do what we do. Why we end up the person that we become. Apakah layak Allah yang menciptakan itu tidak mengetahui dan dia maha halus lagi maha mengetahui. Dialah yang menjadikan bumi untuk kamu yang mudah dijelajahi, maka jelajahilah hingga penjurunya dan makanlah sebahagian daripada rezekinya. Sudah merasa amankah kamu bahawa dia yang di langit itu tidak membuat kamu ditelan bumi ketika dengan tiba-tiba ia bergoncang? Atau sudah merasa amankah kamu bahawa dia di langit itu tidak akan mengirimkan bidai yang menghujani kamu dengan batu, maka kelak kamu akan mengetahui bagaimana akibat mendustakan peringatanku. Atau siapakah yang akan menjadikan bala tentera bagimu yang dapat membelamu selain Allah yang Maha Pengasih? Orang kafir itu hanyalah dalam keadaan tertipu. It says that siapa lagi yang akan membela nasib kita kat dalam dunia ni? We are alive today, we are fine today just because Allah have protected us in many ways. If not, we wouldn't have survived. Kita sebagai manusia yang lemah, we wouldn't make it in this world alone. Tapi kerana kuasa dia, we are still alive. Katakanlah wahai Muhammad, terangkanlah kepadaku jika sumber air kamu menjadi kering, maka siapa yang akan memberimu air yang mengalir? To who else do we ask help from if not from God? You know, no matter how broken you feel, no matter how you rasa the cruelty of this world, macam mana you rasa dunia ni sangat kejam atau unfair, but that's how the world supposed to be. Because Allah tu nak kita minta tolong kepada dia. To who else do we ask help from? So, this is the meaning of the painting. My future plan is to create more art, to be more consistent on it, so that I can, and I want to venture more into canvas art lah. Sebab asyik paper je kan all this while. I want to make more canvas art so that maybe one day I can make a solo exhibition ke. It's my dream lah to have my own exhibition. Even though I didn't become a fashion designer, I didn't, maybe itu cerita lain lah kan. I just have the sketches. Itu maybe one day I will venture into fashion. But for now, my closest plan is to have a solo exhibition lah, insyaAllah. And for word of wisdom, I don't have certain sentence or quotes, but what I want to say is just don't lose your spirit lah. Don't lose your spirit. Although macam if you feel like ini minat saya tapi orang lain tak minat pun apa, saya minat kan. You feel different from other people. But stick on to what you want. If you know what you fighted for at the very first stage, habiskan. And if you tersungkur ke ataupun you rasa macam one day macam I don't feel like I have the interest in art anymore or baking anymore, I don't think I have any interest in any hobby that I have pun, don't worry, just don't throw it yet. Jangan buang lagi, at least put it in one bag, because it's valuable. One day you will look back and you will be proud of yourself. So don't lose spirit. And then one day it will come back and you will bloom and you will be a greater person with a greater skill, greater talent. Yeah.